glory, glory. Amen, amen, amen. Just waiting on this one unit to come on. There we go. Amen. Glory to God. Well, hello everyone. I know no one is up there yet because I just come on, but nevertheless, I'm speaking to you as though you're already there. Amen. And I have a question. I ask that you would touch every heart, every soul under the sound of my voice. And I ask you, Lord, that you would anoint every ear to hear and prepare every heart to receive. Because, Father, your word is true. You're not a man that you should lie. What you said, God, you're able to bring it to pass. So, Father, I do believe that it is your will to heal today. Because when I was sick, Lord God, I had no money, had no insurance, and have no way of getting healed. But, God, you touched my body in a supernatural way. And you healed me, and you delivered me from the pain and the agony that my body was suffering at the time. And so, Father, I thank you so much. And I just praise you, Father, for those that are around me, that you have life, that you have touched, and that you have healed, that you have set free. And they have testimony today as well to share, Father, how you brought them through. Amen. So, Father, I bless your name. I thank you, Father, that your word is alive and health and healing to all our flesh. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, amen. Well, I got a question. My question is today, is it God's will to heal you? Amen. To heal you today. Amen. Let's look at Luke chapter 4 and verse number 14. And let's go from there. Let's just look through the word of God and see, is it God's will for you to be healed? Amen. Me personally, I'm a firm believer. I am a firm believer that it's God's will to heal. But I want you to have that same conviction. Amen. The Bible says in Luke chapter 4 and verse number 14, Luke chapter 4 and verse number 14, and Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee, and there went out a fame of him through all the region round about. Amen. Through all the region round about. Now it goes on to read, and he taught in their synagogues, being glorified of all, and he came to Nazareth where he was brought up. And as his custom was, see, this is the beginning of Jesus' miracles. This is the beginning of Jesus' miracles. Do you believe that God has a miracle for you today? Amen. See, I believe that God wants to touch. I believe God wants to deliver. I believe God wants to set people free today. Amen. Today can be your day of deliverance. Today can be your day that you will experience God's goodness. Amen. God's mercies. Amen. Because I believe that this is a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So now let's look here at what it says. Look at verse number 17, Matthew chapter 4, verse number 17. And there was delivered unto him the book of the prophet Isaiah. And when he had opened the book, he found the place where it was written, the Spirit, and this is what it said now, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he hath anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He had sent me, here it is right here, folks. He has sent me, glory to God, to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captive, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those that are bruised, them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. So I believe that God's will for you to be healed is very, very much true. Amen. Very much true. And I'm going to take you through some scriptures this evening, because I want you to know without a shadow of a doubt that you are in line right now for God to touch your body, that God may touch your body. Amen. I want to look here in the book of, let's go to the book of Acts, the book of Acts. Amen. Now notice here, we see that God gave men what? Power. Amen. Notice what he said in Acts chapter 1 and verse number 8. He said, but ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. You shall be a witness unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the other parts of the earth. Amen. So God gave us power to minister to the hurting people. How do you know, Pastor? Because he says over here in the book of glory to God, Luke chapter 9 and verse number 1. I know y'all say, you use that scripture awful lot. Yes, I do, because it speaks to my heart. It speaks to my heart. Amen. When the word of God speaks to my heart, I know this God speaking to me. Luke chapter 9, verse number 1 said, and then he called the 12 disciples together, and he gave them power and authority over all devils and to cure diseases. I don't know what your disease may be. I don't know what your illness may be. But I know that we serve a God that is able to cure you right now. I remember when God first started using me along the line of healing, I was going to the jailhouses. I was going to the prisons. I was going to the convalescent homes. I was going to the hospitals. Amen. I did it on a weekly basis. Amen. And so when I went to the prison, I was preaching to the population in the prison, on the prison yard. And then after I'd done ministering to the prison in the population group, the warden came to me and said, we have a man on death row. Would you like to minister to them? And I was kind of skeptical at first, but you know what? I was compelled of the Lord to go to the death row people and minister to them. But, you know, that was a very scary part right there, because you see, they already on death row and they don't care who they hurt. You know, and I'm thinking, wow, I'm a preacher and I'm going here amongst all these devils. I was pretty scared at the time. But you know what? God showed up and God delivered those people. I began to minister to those people. And as I was done ministering to the people on death row in the prison, now God, I'm starting to pray for them, starting to minister to them. And as I'm praying for this one man, God said, pray, because a lot of those people on death row had AIDS. A lot of those people on death row, they had AIDS and stuff like that, because they didn't care about what their lifestyle, because they was already on death row. They was getting ready to die. They didn't care about what they was doing. So a lot of them had AIDS and stuff. And so God, as I was praying for these men, God said, pray for the blood system. The disease is in the blood system. And so I learned a very valuable lesson there as I was praying for these prison inmates. Amen. That was on death row. God spoke to me very, very firm and very strong. Said, the disease is in the blood system. Pray for the blood system. Amen. And so I was praying for this man. And while I'm praying for this man, God started to talk to me. And then I had to, as God was talking to me, I turned my prayer around to go in alignment to what God was saying. Amen. And as I did, I began to take authority and over the blood system. I began to take authority over the disease that was in the blood system, over the virus that was in the blood system. And I began to rebuke that virus. I began to rebuke that AIDS, amen, that was in the blood system. And lo and behold,